Hi friends, welcome to Easy Ways. So welcome to this particular lecture where we're going to have a discussion regarding some important current affairs question from the month of December 2018. So this lecture is part of a series which is current affairs coverage for CLAT and AILET 2019 examination. This is part 3 wherein we'll be discussing 50 questions. And guys, as we know that the CLAT examination is going to be held on 12th of May 2019 and AILET examination on 5th of May 2019. Let us begin. So the first question for today, guys, it is which High Court has ordered a ban on sale of online medicines by e-pharmacists across India on 12th of December 2018? The answer for this particular question is Delhi High Court. Important, star mark this question, friends. So coming to question number 2, friends, it says the Reserve Bank of India has announced that India's CAD, that is current account deficit, has widened to dash percentage of the GDP, that is gross domestic product, in the July-September quarter of the current fiscal. Now friends, let me tell you the intention behind putting across this question. So firstly, you don't need to memorize this particular percentage because we will be getting newer estimates, okay? But still, you need to understand that certain important terms are being dealt with here. Like when you talk about Reserve Bank of India, the banker of banks, okay? So you need to know the full form. You need to know the act with which it came into being, that Reserve Bank of India Act 1934. Right, then the other term, current account deficit, CAD, you need to know the full form of it, GDP, gross domestic product, right? And let me tell you, when you talk about fiscal year, okay, so if you say the current fiscal year is 2019 fiscal year, that means it started on 1st of April, okay, 2018, and it ends on 31st of March, okay, 2019. Right? So you need to know this financial year as well as fiscal year, right? Now the answer for this particular question, it is 2.9%, but don't memorize this as of now. Just concentrate upon the various important points that I told you. Okay? Moving to question number 3, friends. So NABARD, that is National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, has signed a loan agreement worth how much with Green Climate Fund to boost rooftop solar power capacity projects through private sector participation. Okay. So the answer for this particular question is USD 100 million. Okay. So let me just tell you the intention behind coming up with this particular question. There are important full forms that you need to know. You need to know about Green Climate Fund. Okay. GCF. You need to know about NABARD. There might be a very simple question wherein they might ask you to just expand NABARD. Okay. Moving to question number 4, which bank has approved a $400 million loan for a water sanitation project in Andhra Pradesh? The answer for this particular question is Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. Now friends, there is a little homework for you guys, and if you have been following our series throughout, you need to tell me the headquarters of ADP, the headquarters of AIIB, and the headquarters of World Bank. Now this forms a portion of static GK and you should know the answers by now. Right? Moving to question number 5, friends. So which entity announced that it will implement an ombudsman scheme for digital transactions covering services provided by entities falling under Reserve Bank's regulatory jurisdiction? The answer is obviously the Reserve Bank of India, RBI. Moving to question number 6, star mark this question, friends. Name the 24th governor of the Reserve Bank of India who resigned on 10th December 2018. So he was the 24th governor. The answer is Dr. Urjit Patel. So he has given his resignation. Moving to question number 7, again star mark this question, friends. Who was appointed as the 25th governor of the Reserve Bank of India on 11th of December 2018? The answer is Shakti Kanta Das. Okay, again an important question, friends. Moving to question number 8. So the Securities and Exchange Board of India, SEBI, approved the proposal of clubbing of investment limits for foreign portfolio investors on the basis of common ownership of more than how much percentage of common control, excluding the case of regulated public retail funds? So friends, the answer for this particular question is 50%. Now again, the motive, I want you to be aware of certain terms like SEBI. You need to expand that, Securities and Exchange Board of India. So friends, where is the headquarter of SEBI? Kindly mention the answer in the comment section below. Okay. And secondly, if you see a term called FPI, so the full form is Foreign Portfolio Investments. Okay. Moving to question number 9. So which country has won the 9th edition of International Admirals Cup Regatta 2018, which is held in Ethicullam Beach at Indian Naval Academy, Azimila, Kerala? The answer for this particular question, it is Italy. Okay, so these are important sports events taking place. Okay, moving to question number 10. So when was the Indian Armed Forces Flag Day observed throughout India? Okay, important days. The answer for this particular question is December 7. Okay. So coming to question number 11, friends. So when did Indian Navy celebrate Submarine Day to commemorate the induction of the first submarine, the erstwhile INS Kalvari, into the Navy in 1967? The answer for this particular question is December 8. So we are having a look on the important days. Moving to question number 12, friends. The 10th edition of Indra Navy, the bilateral exercise between the navies of India and which country, started at Vishakhapatnam on 9th of December 2018. So important exercises. Okay, so already we have seen a lot of them. Now again we are seeing one. It is called Indra Navy. The answer is Russia. Okay, so it is between the navies of India and Russia. Moving to question number 13, friends, where was the Military Literature Festival 2018 held in December? So the answer is Chandigarh, okay, Union Territory. So friends, coming to question number 14, so name the second edition of the 11-day exercise between Indian Air Force and Russian Federation Aerospace Force that commenced at Air Force Station Jodhpur. So friends, previously we saw a question that was regarding navies of India and Russia. Okay, we saw that particular exercise. Now we are talking about Indian Air Force and Russian Federation Aerospace Force. Okay, the answer is Avia Indra 2018. Okay. Moving to question number 15, friends. Indian Navy's first flyaway deep sea submarine rescue system was inducted by Chief of Naval Staff Admiral Sunil Lamba. So it will be operated and deployed by submarine rescue unit from its base in which city? The answer is Mumbai. Okay. And another important fact you can see out here is Chief of our Naval Staff, that is Admiral Sunil Lamba. So this is again one potential question. Okay. So coming to question number 16, friends, a currency swap agreement was signed between which Indian bank and the Central Bank of UAE on 4th of December 2018? The answer for this particular question, the Central Bank of India, that is Reserve Bank of India, RBI. Okay, now friends, you need to tell me some important facts. Kindly write that down in the comment section below. So which is the capital of UAE? The first question for today. And the second one, what is the currency of UAE? Now friends, these small things would matter a lot. Okay, so as soon as you see this question, pause this video, Google the answer. It will stay in your mind for long. Okay, moving to question number 17, friends. So which software company has announced that it will shut down its messaging app Allo in March 2019 after 2.5 years of debut? The answer is Yahoo. Okay, so you can see that the messaging app Allo is related to Yahoo. Okay, so next particular question, which country became the world's leading exporter of liquefied natural gas for the first time? Okay, the answer is Australia. Okay, so this is again an important fact. Moving to question number 19, who has resigned as CEO of online fashion retailer Myntra? The answer for this particular question, Anant Narayanan. Okay. So next question number 20, where was the annual India Water Impact Summit held? The answer is New Delhi. Okay. Question number 21, where was a Global Venture Capital Summit held? The answer is Goa. Okay, so we are talking about a Global Venture Capital Summit. Okay. So coming to question number 22, friends, where was the first international conference on wares held from 3rd to 6th December 2018? The answer for this particular question is Agra, that is in UP. Agra, known for Taj Mahal. Moving to question number 23, India signed an MOU on development cooperation in Africa with which country for establishing a center of excellence in information technology in Ethiopia? The answer for this particular question is UAE. So we are having a look at so many questions featuring UAE. So definitely you need to tell me the capital and currency of it, right? Moving to question number 24, where did External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj co-inaugurate Gandhi Zayed Digital Museum? Important question, friends. The answer for this particular question, Abu Dhabi, UAE. Okay. Moving to question number 25, India signed an agreement with which country to pay for the crude oil it imports from the country in rupees? Okay. The answer for this question is Iran. Okay. Moving to question number 26, which airlines became the first Indian carrier to have 200 aircraft in its fleet? Okay, important. Star mark this question. The answer is Indigo. Okay. Moving to question number 27, friends. What was the theme of International Civil Aviation Day celebrated on 7th of December 2018? So the first important information that you can take from this question is, when is International Civil Aviation Day celebrated? It is 7th of December. The theme is working together to ensure no country is left behind. So they are basically talking about connectivity, right? And let me tell you, every day, each year, there's a new theme connected to it. So you need to know the theme as well, plus the important day, okay? Moving to question number 28, the Kannur International Airport Limited was inaugurated in which state? The answer is Kerala. Okay, so Kannur is a place there as well. Moving to question number 29, when was the 16th International Anti-Corruption Day observed by the United Nations? The answer is December 9. So again, a question on important day. Moving to question number 30, where was the 54th Scotch Summit on the State of Power, Oil and Gas held? So the answer is Delhi. Okay. Moving to question number 31, friends, where did UNICEF, United Nations International Children Emergency Fund, celebrate its 71st Foundation Day? The answer is December 11. Now, friends, here, more than the Foundation Day, another important aspect that you need to keep in mind is the full form of UNICEF. Okay, simple questions like this can also be asked. Okay. Moving to question number 32. So what was the theme of the International Mountain Day 2018, which was celebrated on 11th of December 2018? So what is the takeaway? International Mountain Day celebrated on 11th of December. The theme is hashtag mountains matter. Okay. Moving to question number 33. Arun Kumar Shaw passed away following a prolonged illness in Kolkata. So he was a national champion and first dash to win Arjuna Award from Bengal. So this is an important question related to obituary. The answer is swimmer. So Arun Kumar Shaw was a swimmer. Okay. So whenever you're seeing a particular question on obituary, the important facts about that personality should be remembered. Okay. Moving to question number 34. So Muhammad Azharul Haq passed away on 7th of December. What was his profession? The answer is politician. Okay. Moving to question number 35, friends. So Belisario Betancourt passed away on 8th of December 2018. So he was the former president of which country? The answer is Colombia. Okay. So guys, again, you need to tell me the capital of Colombia, right? Moving to question number 36. So Nebankar Gupta, popularly known as Nobby, who had served at several major companies, died. So he belonged to which field? The answer is marketing. Okay, so Nebankar Gupta, popularly known as Nobby. Moving to question number 37. So Russia's Lyudmila Alexeyeva died on 8th of December 2018. So she was a Russian human rights activist. So important. Moving to question number 38, friends. So CN Balakrishnan passed away in Kochi, Kerala. So he was also a politician. Okay. Moving to question number 39, friends. Which pair has become India's second inland water transport origin destination pair for containerized cargo movement on National Waterway 1? Okay. So we are talking about connectivity through the route of water. Okay. So it is National Waterway 1 we are talking about. Okay. So we are looking for a pair of origin destination. Okay. So the answer is, it is Kolkata-Patna. Okay. Moving to question number 40, where was the world's largest Arabic audio library launched? Okay. The answer is Dubai, United Arab Emirates. So a lot of questions featuring UAE today, right? So important, star mark this question. Moving to question number 41, Roshni Nadar Malhotra, Kiran Mazumdar Shaw, Shobhana Bhartiya and Dash are the four Indians featured in the world's 100 most powerful women of 2018 released by Forbes. The answer is Priyanka Chopra. Okay, so these kind of questions are asked regarding your Forbes list. Okay, moving to question number 42, who has retained the position of top newsmaker in India in the year 2018 according to Yahoo Year in Review list? The answer is Mr. Narendra Modi. Okay. Moving to question number 43, name the person who's the most followed leader on Instagram according to Twiplomacy study 2018 conducted by Burson Marsteller, an international public relations and communications firm. The answer is Mr. Narendra Modi, so you can see how famous. Next, question number 44, which district became the 23rd district of Arunachal Pradesh on 9th of December 2018? The answer is Shiyomi, okay? And one more question for you guys, if you have been listening to our lectures, which is the 25th High Court in India, okay? You need to tell the answer in the comment section below. So moving to question number 45, friends. So which entity has conducted the largest ever Central Teacher Eligibility Test, CTET, at 2144 centers in 92 cities across India on 9th of December? The answer is Central Board of Secondary Education, that is CBSE. So CBSE is the authority that conducts the Central Teacher Eligibility Test. Moving to question number 46. So Indian Railway Catering and Tourism Corporation launched the Buddhist Circuit Tourism Train, okay, which will tour for how many days across several cities? The answer is 16 days, okay? So you need to know about this Buddhist Circus Tourist Train, okay? Now, 47th question, United Nations Conference adopted a global pact, which is called the Global Pact for Safe, Orderly and Regular Migration on 10th of December 2018. So where was this United Nations Conference held? So the answer for this particular question, it is Marrakesh, Morocco. Okay. Moving to question number 48. So the Union Cabinet has approved the implementation of Shahpur Kandi Dam project on River Ravi in Punjab with central assistance of how many rupees for irrigation component for over 5 years from 1819 to 2022-23. The answer is 485.38 crore. Now friends, more than the allocation, what else is important? So here you can get a question that this particular dam project, which is called Shahpur Kandi Dam project, it is on which river? Okay, so this is a potential question. So you need to know that it is on the River Ravi in Punjab. Okay. Moving to question number 49. So Union Cabinet approved a MOU between India and which country that was signed in June 2018 focused on postage stamp and following which commemorative postage stamps including the depiction of Manipuri dance of India were released. Okay. So the answer for this particular question, it is Armenia. Okay. Important. So the last question for today, guys, it is Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has notified amendments, okay, to Central Motor Vehicle Rules 1989 and announced that all new vehicles will be sold pre-fitted with the high security registration plates from, so the answer is 1st of April 2019, okay. So friends, if you want to download the PDF of this particular lecture so you can revise them before the exam, you can go to our website www.easyway.co.in. You can either log in or sign up. If you are a previous subscriber, you need to just log in. If you are new, you need to sign up. You can enroll in the free course and download this particular PDF. So friends, the course would be looking like this. And apart from that, we also offer a current affair test series and it would include the months June 2018 to June 1st week 2019. There would also be notes on 50 plus static GK topics. And the price is going to be ₹799. And friends, yes, that's it for today. We are at the end of this particular lecture wherein we discuss 50 important questions from the month of December 2018. Now, friends, don't worry. The examination is nearing. I know that most of you might be nervous. Okay. And we shall soon be coming out with certain tidbits to help you guys throughout the left out 2.5 months. Right. So, and if you found this video useful, do like, subscribe and share. Kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon. Share our videos, friends. We have really been working hard for this. And if you have any queries regarding strategy, regarding time management, do mail us at mailateasyway@gmail.com. You can also give us a call on 8968984790. Until then, friends, as I always keep telling you, keep practicing, keep revising. Thank you so much.